Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Lena and today we're going to talk about a few ways to save money on your groceries even if you have food sensitivities or allergies. If you're new to the channel, welcome. I'm so glad you're here. On this channel, I like to talk about things about money and saving money and also about how to make life at home a little simpler. If you are at the beginning of your food allergy journey or food sensitivity journey, welcome. I'm so glad you're here. It will get better with time. Those first couple of years are so hard and there are so many adjustments to make, but I want to give you a few tips about how we don't have to give up on our food budget and just be like, whatever, we're just gonna spend $1 million on food because my diet is restrictive and I don't know what we're gonna eat. I know this is a temptation because, you know, there's all those cool products out there now. There wasn't 10 years ago when I started eliminating foods from my diet, but now there's so many yummy, like gluten-free muffins and alternative foods, and they're so expensive. And if you feel like that's your only option for how you're gonna manage your allergies, it gets so, so expensive. So don't give up on saving money on food and making a real difference in your budget with the food, even if your diet is complicated. And let me tell you, my diet is the epitome of complicated. So a little bit about me, we're not gonna go into that right now exactly, but some of the main things that I avoid would be gluten and dairy and basically all grains. How do we deal with this at the grocery store and still save a lot of money? I see these how to eat for $10 a week or something videos on YouTube and I'm like, And then I'm like, okay, let's see what they've got. Oh, we had spaghetti and then we had tacos and then we had French toast for breakfast. And I'm like, well, actually I can't eat any of those foods without getting seriously ill. So what's the answer for saving money when it's complicated? So here are just a few of the things that have really helped us along the way. My first tip is to shop once a week with a list. This one tip helps you avoid so many other pitfalls that this is, in my mind, this is the golden ticket for trying to save money. At least for us, if we run out of something essential, like eggs, and we go to the store for eggs, we start thinking of other things that we need and or would be nice or would make our life run more smoothly. We add them to the list, and before you know it, the simple trip to the store for eggs results in at least a $50 trip. And if you do that once a week or twice a week, that really starts to add up. So that's the first pitfall that you're avoiding when you only go to the store once a week, is you're avoiding those add-on items that you could have waited a few more days for, but you're at the store already, so you might as well get it. Another pitfall that our family avoids when we only go to the store once a week is not eating all of the food that's actually in our fridge. So if you have to stretch things at the end a little bit, like, oh man, I wonder exactly how we're gonna make dinner or what we're gonna eat or something like that, that helps you look in the back of the fridge, eat those last vegetables that you were kind of avoiding or before they go bad too. So this creates less waste in your budget and less food in the trash. I know that it is very common for a lot of food to go to waste just by accident, and I think by the fact that people go to the store too soon and they aren't forced to look in the fridge and figure out what they're gonna do. And even if that means on Friday night and you're not planning on going to the store till Saturday, you're like, well, there's nothing. I guess we're eating frozen green beans and waffles. If you only go to the store one time a week, you can also avoid impulse shopping or shopping for one special meal at a time. So this is super tempting if you get one of those magazines and I've got those cool recipes and they're like, you need marmalade and then you need this special thing and then, and they're all things you don't have and of course they're all expensive things. By setting a family rule to only go to the store once a week, you're also avoiding those one-time specialty ingredients that you might buy for a meal. So for us, it works best to go shopping on the weekends because we have a little bit more time. Because I feel like when we shop on weekdays, even though it's less busy, we would shop in the evening and we would already have had long days of work and we'd be tired, which means our critical thinking skills would be a little bit lower and we'd just be like, oh, that looks yummy. Instead of, if we get this huge bag of carrots, we could do soup with it, and then we could do curry with it, and then we could do this other thing with it. We're not thinking like that because we're just like, I need to get home and go to bed because I'm so tired. Okay, so my next tip is to avoid those expensive look-alike products that they sell at the store. So this means if you've got gone gluten-free, that you don't buy the gluten-free muffins or the gluten-free donuts or all the alternatives to the things that you were buying before. This is so tempting at the beginning. And this is, we did this at the beginning of my journey too. We would try to like buy a bread replacement. And not only is it expensive, it was often disgusting. And gluten-free bread has gotten so much better tasting, but it is still pretty expensive. And it's not necessarily great for you, or it doesn't necessarily have more nutritional value than the gluten version. This means that you need to have a few fun foods that you know are gonna work for your tummy and your body and are also, you can make them at home. So I'm thinking, what kind of snacks can I make that are inexpensive and what kind of desserts? So that I don't feel like I'm missing out on life because I decided that these things weren't working for my body, so that you don't give up. So I'm sure you'll come up with your own weird snacks, but at least for me, one of my favorite snacks is puffed millet and then sunflower seed butter and maple syrup. And you just mix it together in a cup and it's really good. And it's sweet and it's salty and it's got some protein in it and some carbs in it. And that really hits the spot and helps me from buying some specialty thing at the store. Another fun snack that I have made is candied chickpeas. You can make candied chickpeas in your oven with a bag of chickpeas that you bought for $1.80 at the store and some sugar. So that can be a really fun, crunchy, sweet protein snack for under $2 for a whole batch, so that can be really fun too. Another great place to look for treats that will work with your diet is Alana's Pantry, and I'll link the website down below. This lady knows what she's doing and she knows how to work with all those alternative flours and stuff. And so if you're really craving something awesome, you don't want to buy the version at the store because it has so many extra things in it. Go to Alana's Pantry on her website and find one of those and make it, and it'll be amazing. Because some gluten-free recipes are just gross. Or like take you 5 million hours and it's obnoxious. It doesn't have to be that way. Just go to this website and you can find something yummy. Let me know down in the comments what your strategies are for saving money in your food budget, even if you have food sensitivities. Thank you so much for watching my video. It really means a lot to me. Please hit the like button and the subscribe button, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye for now.